back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Now, if you're new, consider hitting that subscribe button and giving this video a like. It truly does help the channel out. So, my sisters are here, so you already know we came to the theater. We came to see Marvel's newest film, Eternals, and we are here to talk about it. We are on a row now with back-to-back nighttime movie coming. Well, she wasn't here the last time, but yeah, no. So the light is kind of bad, and look, we're looking pretty rough. So the Eternals is a race of immortal beings with superhuman powers who have secretly lived on Earth for thousands of years, reunite to battle the evil deviant. Now, this is directed by the wonderful Chloe Zhao. Of course, she did win her. Oh, am I boring you already?
Sorry, I'm sleepy.
Yeah, it's late, you guys. It's 10 o'clock. It's way past my bedtime. She's an amazing director, and you can truly see her work in here. It is beautiful. It's different, you guys. It is a different Marvel type of movie.
It had a different feel to it.
Phase 4 just seems totally different, because even with like Shang-Chi, that had a different vibe feel to it. That felt a little bit more Marvel though compared to this. This is definitely like Marvel for adults, but maybe
it seems more evolved.
I feel like this movie is not really gonna go very well with like hardcore Marvel fans, because you're not gonna get like Marvel stuff here. Like there's like fighting. Are you still playing with the light? There's like
no, I see her making her face.
Oh Lord! God. There's still that Marvel little bit of humor, but it's more just like a little dash. They don't overdo it with it.
I'll go first because I don't really know what to say because of how it's.
But
so
it's Marvel,
different.
You know.
Yeah,
Marvel. You see, you're talking about me. We're also sleep deprived.
I really love Marvel and of all the films and all that. Even though this, of course, how you said Phase 4. Phase 4, right?
Yes.
It's completely different, but I like it. It's it gives you a different view of who's saving the world and what other creatures are out there besides the
Avengers.
The Avengers. Yeah, but I really enjoyed it. It was really cool of seeing them being their superhero selves, not becoming. Living their lives.
Yeah, because they're immortal.
Yeah.
Do you imagine?
No, I don't want to. I'm surprised I lived this long.
I really like how it was shot, as like the awesomeness of the picture.
Cinematography. Yeah. Yeah.
And that all word. That word. And how they were, all the edits of making everything like seem so cool. Go. Even though a lot of them don't really have that cool superpowers of like fighting, but they're still really important part of the group.
I'm gonna be like this right now. All you gotta know is I enjoyed it. I'm a little tired, so I'm probably wasn't as invested into it as I normally would have been, but I did enjoy it. I like the shots, the
cinematography,
that word. Like the action, of course, they've got that humor in there, so dude, you still laugh a couple times.
The character development for me was really, really good. I love, love, love this ensemble. I love the diversity here. One thing though that just came out today is that this movie's actually banned like in Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, I think it is, and Qatar. There he goes. Yeah, you know, I can't talk. Because you know, over there it's illegal. Same-sex marriages and same-sex stuff. Yeah. It's illegal. Mm-hmm. So because there is a same-sex couple here, and because there is a kissing scene here, which wasn't even done like bad, you guys. It was so tasteful. It was like a goodbye kiss. It was beautiful. But because of their beliefs over there, they banned this movie because Disney refused to take that scene out of the movie. There are two post-credit scenes here, so make sure you stay for them. The first one is actually the better one, but the second one does kind of continue on with how the movie actually ended. So if you're curious about what happens with the particular character there, you get another little like taste to it. I truly, truly do hope that this does get a sequel. This movie has been getting terrible reviews. There are...
Honestly, I'm not surprised.
Terrible reviews. It's like I said,
I enjoyed it, but yeah. I didn't love it.
Nobody's ready for what they have in the future for Marvel.
No.
They're trying to evolve into different things, and people are not
wanting to evolve with them. They want the same stuff.
And Yeah,
like the something. Fun and the super like action and like the witty the stuff, and this is not that. No. This is not that.
Yeah,
this
don't expect.
Yeah, this.
Like, I mean, it's got its funny little things.
Like very little, tiny.
How long were you together?
5,000 years.
I guess you can call that long term.
First time that we've been to the movies since the pandemic that we've actually been like in a full theater. The crowd was great. We laughed when we were supposed to laugh or chuckle, and then we shut up and focus when we were supposed to. Now the movie's about 2.5 hours, and honestly, I could have gone for just a little bit more. I'm not gonna lie, because the story,
I mean, you do get left with what's next.
Yeah. And then like I feel like some stories could have maybe been flushed out just a tiny bit more. Oh, we do have a lot of flashbacks, and that seems to be a lot of the main issue. There are Eternals. We have 7,000 years of stuff that they've gone through. Obviously, we don't go through like all the 7,000 years. We skip to some of the like the pinpoints, I guess, in their life. I personally don't have a problem with the pacing, but it is, I guess, like a slower pace. Before we do give you our score, don't forget to give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit notification bell so you'll be notified each time that I post something new. So, what are you giving
it?
Look at this straw, it's like dissolving.
I'll give it a medium with this.
With the soda.
I'm between the small and the medium.
You're part of the problem. I'm giving it a medium.
I know it's definitely not a small.
Mm-hmm.
I guess.
So it's a medium?
A small with a soda and some candy.
Okay, it's just, it's different. But I was totally here for it, and I can't wait to see where the journey's gonna take us, you guys.
I like where they're taking it.
Uh-huh.
It's just gonna take some time to get there.
Yeah, because I mean, all the other Marvel movies, you guys, are just pure fun. They are pure fun, and this is beautiful storytelling, beautiful visuals. That's what I'm saying. It's like more adultish.
It has a feel of when you're reading the book and you're seeing it all in your mind.
Yes, that is a really good, because again, it's because they're telling the story very beautifully. All right, guys, that's it from us today. If you've seen Eternals, let us know down below. What did you think about it? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Was it just not for you? Are you planning on checking it out? Are you gonna pass on it? I don't know when it's gonna come out on Disney Plus, like 3 months from now. I think that's usually around the time, you guys, it literally just came on theaters. It's just gonna be in theaters. I don't think it's gonna be for that $30 rental. All right, guys, that's it from us tonight. We'll see you next time at concessions. I'm going to bed. Bye. Well, we're going to go home and then go to bed. Bye.